Yeah. Doing well, eh? Mic check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mic check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for being here at today's wonderful announcement. Bonjour à tous, merci d'être présent à la séance d'aujourd'hui. I want to start by acknowledging that we are gathered on Treaty 1 territory and that Manitoba is located on the treaty territories and ancestral lands of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Ojibwe, Dakota, and Dene peoples. I wish to further acknowledge that Manitoba is located on the homeland of the Red River Métis. We respect the spirit and intent of treaties and treaty making and remain committed to working in partnership with First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people in the spirit of truth, reconciliation, and collaboration. My name is Rochelle Squires and I'm the Minister of Families, and I'm pleased to be joined here by my colleagues, the Minister of Consumer Protection and Government Services, the Honorable James Teitsma, the Minister of Education and Early Childhood Learning, the Honorable Wayne Ewasko. With us as well is the President of the Winnipeg Construction Association, Ron Hambley, and the Board Chair for the River East Transcona School Division, Colleen Carswell. Thank you all for being here today. And we also are honored to have special guests here, the leadership group from this wonderful school that are here today to join us for this special announcement. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome Minister James Teitsma to the podium to make that announcement.
Thank you very much. I'm very pleased to be here. Thank you, Rochelle, for the introduction. And special thank you to the leadership team they're all smiling. They're super, super pumped to be here. And yet they are fully aware that this beautiful construction project that's happening right behind me right now will only benefit their younger siblings and not them, because they're all going to graduate from this school before the completion date. But nonetheless, they're very upbeat and positive. And I love that attitude. I love that energy that you're bringing. Today's an exciting announcement. What we're announcing today is that we're investing in Manitoba's education capital infrastructure. We are making significant investments, not just building new schools, of which we are doing lots, but also of doing additions, of building multi-purpose rooms, of adding gymnasiums, of adding classrooms. In all, $260 million in new and continuing school capital projects are being done in fiscal 23-24. And these investments include $90 million for renovations, $104 million for new schools, and $66 million for renewing existing infrastructure. These projects are going to have a significant impact on education in our province, with 1 million square feet and 375 new classrooms, as well as all sorts of specialized spaces and multi-purpose learning spaces. What I will say too is included in the backgrounder for this event is an overview of all the projects that we've done since 2019 as government. And as government, we have 321 education capital projects. 321 projects. That is an astonishing number of projects. That includes 14 new schools that are already part of our 2019-2020 school funding guarantee, seven of which are already complete, seven of which are underway. And we recently announced an additional 9 new schools for a total of 23 new schools that will get built by our government. What I want to say here is that the approach that this government has taken to the development of capital infrastructure is an approach that gets things done. We're a government that gets things done, and you can see that by our commitment, and we're doing it based on student needs. I can tell you I see Colleen Carswell here from River East Transcona. I'm the area MLA, not just the minister of responsible for building schools, but I'm the area MLA. And I remember many discussions with River East Transcona about how to select which projects to move forward with. And I'm proud to say that on that list of 321 school projects, 16 of them are right here in River East Transcona. And the projects that are getting done, thank you. The projects that are getting done are the projects that the parents, the students, the school trustees, the board, that they put forward, that they work together, that they realize are the priorities for this division. And I want to give a special shout out to River East Transcona, because I think they have taken a very measured, a very detailed-oriented approach to assessing their capital needs and having a great relationship with myself, with government officials, in putting forward great projects like the amazing one that you see right behind me. And this one, I believe, was I was talking to you about 4 years ago, 5 years ago. It's so great to see it come to fruition because you could see the projection of student enrollment. You could see the increased need in French milieu, and you made plans to address that need, and then our government could support you in those plans. That's how education capital should get developed. It's done in a way that's nonpartisan, that doesn't depend on who the MLA for the area is. I'll just mention, I think Winnipeg School Division, for example, I'm not sure if there's any MLAs from our government in Winnipeg School Division. I don't think there are. And yet 65 of the 321 projects that are on the background here today, 65 of them are in Winnipeg School Division. That shows that we are addressing needs, that we are taking an approach that values what students need, what parents need, and what school division, our school division partners, put forward as their needs, and we're making choices in that way. That's why I'm so proud of our government, and I'm super impressed again to see a continued investment, $260 million in school education capital in this year, with much more to come in the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you for that wonderful announcement. Now it is my pleasure to invite my colleague, who has certainly spent many, many years in schools and in schoolyards as an academic, and now is the Minister of Early Learning, Childhood Education and Education, the Honourable Wayne Ewasko.
Thanks, Minister Spicer. Oh, it's all good. It's all good. Good morning, everyone. I'd like to first thank, of course, the students from Ecole Regent Park, the leadership team, Go Scorpions, for joining us here this morning for this great announcement. I'd like to thank Principal Grande and Vice Principal Uppinger for hosting us here this morning as well. I know I'm joined by Rob and Colleen, and also Assistant Superintendent as well with River East Transcona School Division. I'd like to thank Minister Squires for agreeing to MC this morning, and I'd like to thank teammate Minister Teitsma for this great announcement. As he's already said, we do many joint things, and as a government, it's not just the education department, it's not just consumer protection and government services, it's not just families. It's each and every department coming together and making sure that we're moving forward, as Minister Teitsma has said, the needs of our students in this great province of ours. Avec l'augmentation du nombre de communautés, les familles manitobaines ont besoin de cours de qualité pour répondre aux besoins éducatifs de nos enfants et de nos jeunes. With our growing communities, Manitoba families need quality schools to meet the education needs of our children and our youth. And Manitoba students needs the best possible environments to learn, grow, and reach their full potential. I'm pleased that our government is investing more than $260 million and continuing school capital projects during the 23-24 school year. These investments are going to ensure that Manitoba schools keep up with the growing enrollment, and that our schools need to continue to be essential parts of our education system and the wider community. And they will help our schools give Manitoba children and their families high quality educational experiences and provide the resources that students need to get the most out of their education. These investments include more than $90 million for renovations and additions, $104 million for new schools, and $66 million for existing infrastructure renewal. Investments in infrastructure renewal are often essential deferred maintenance investments that the previous government did not feel the need to prioritize given there was no ribbon cutting ceremonies. And as Minister Teitsma had mentioned, there is a long list of projects that have been embarked upon over the last 4 years and years prior to that are based on those student needs and community needs, no matter which area of the province they are. School projects that will be in progress in the 23-24 will increase school space by over 1 million square feet. Through additions and new school buildings, the projects will create 375 new classrooms, as well as specialized and multi-purpose learning spaces, such as gymnasiums, libraries, and spaces for vocational learning. Capital investments like new classrooms and schools ensures smaller class sizes so that Manitoba students are in their ideal learning environments. Thank you to all of our partners for their hard work on this. This will make a noticeable difference for thousands of Manitoba children and their families. I would also like to thank the school divisions across this great province of ours for their work in providing quality education to students in Manitoba. I look forward to the work being complete and joining our partners to celebrate. I wish each and every student that has joined us today and all my teacher, former colleagues and staff of all school divisions a very safe and enjoyable upcoming summer. Thank you, everybody. Merci and miigwech. Place that there, maybe.
We'll put it right there. Okay. Thank you very much, Minister Ewasko. And yeah, three more days of school and counting, but who's keeping track of that? Certainly not these students here, and probably not their teachers either. So now it is my pleasure to invite to the podium. We would like to have Ron to say a few words about this wonderful project. Ron Hambley.
Thank you, Minister Squires. Thanks, Ministers Ewasko and Teitsma and trustees and all you students here. I'm very, very pleased to be involved in this announcement here today in support of significant capital expenditures in the education infrastructure in our province of Manitoba. Our association represents building contractors like the ones you see behind us from around the province, and we're really pleased to see the level of commitment to new and renovated schools, renovated school construction, particularly pleased to hear that some of them have options for vocational training, which is really important to our industry. With immigration and economic growth accelerating, the need for new and upgraded schools, the local construction industry is committed to delivery of these top quality products and top quality learning environments, certainly for the next generation of students. These projects represent an investment in the future of our province and will provide hundreds and hundreds of jobs, construction jobs, during their construction. On behalf of the Winnipeg Construction Association and its members, thanks very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And last but certainly not least, I would like to invite Colleen Carswell to the podium to say a few words on behalf of the River East School Division.
Thank you very much. Bonjour. Good morning, everyone. And welcome to the best kept secret in Transcona, Ecole Regent Park. Right, scorpions? Schools like this across our school division are the cornerstones of our communities. They are filled with incredible students who are learning to be inspired, educated, and responsible citizens. They are supported by teachers and staff who are committed to excellence each and every day, who create learning experiences that allow our students to thrive. Schools are also places where our communities gather to enjoy preschool programming, before and after school programs, as well as a place to connect with one another for athletic events and extracurricular activities. So in order for this to happen, our school buildings themselves need to be safe and sound structures that provide the kind of learning spaces that meet the needs of our students. Whether it's elevators, grooming rooms, additional classroom spaces, or roof replacements, all are necessary renovations that not only modernize our schools, but they increase accessibility and safety as well. In closing, I would like to thank the Manitoba government and for their investment here into not only Ecole Regent Park that we're standing in front of, but for all of the investments they have made right across our great school division of River East Transcona School Division. But here at Ecole Regent Park, the new gymnasium and additional classrooms will be great assistance to us as we strive to meet our ever-growing population here in River East Transcona School Division. thank you very much. Merci.
Thank you very much for your support and for your words today. Now that concludes the official part of this program, but the ministers and the speakers are all available for questions should the media have any.